Got to turn that mic on. Hello, everyone. Let me check my levels. Levels. I think I'm okay. I have my little level monitor right over there. Can everybody hear me okay? Is it loud and clear? All right. We have DR Guitars in the house. Dude, what's up? Christopher, Jordan, home. Max Reverse, long time no see, dude. I hope you're doing okay. The Dank Savage, Gary Davlin, baby. Yoda, Jordan, James, Gizmo, dude. Lefty Mike, how is everyone doing this evening? What can you see? Oh, you're looking at pedals. Let's do that. Let's look at me. Sounds good. Good. Everything, levels are okay. Guitars, pedals, my voice. Grandpa Joe, hello. Wishing everyone a happy and safe holiday season. Thank you, dude. AQ Music, hello. So AQ, Grandpa Joe, DR, I think, you know, tomorrow night, Patreon show, right? See you there, 10:30-ish, same time as always. Quentin James, hello. John Doe, Jay Burrow, Dylan. You can hear me just fine. Okay, perfect. Good. Ron Cantrell, hello. Jordan, Jeff. Good. Sound is good. So, we are nearing the end of the year. Next week is, I think, the last live show of the year, if I'm not mistaken. I don't have my calendar up right now, but I think it's, I think we're nearing the end of the year. is next Friday? Let me see, actually. Hang on. Let me see what the calendar looks like. Calendar says, yes, next Friday is the last Friday show of the month. Actually, I'm going to do it Saturday because Friday is Christmas and I celebrate Christmas. So I'll do a live show Saturday night. That'll be the plan. So in case you haven't, in case you didn't see the teaser video, I know I've spoken about this a long time. I put some teasers out there, but the my single is officially done. I'm really happy about that. And that will premiere tomorrow at noon Eastern. So the official video, I released the video with the song. Even though the song is already out there on pretty much every social media channel like Spotify, Amazon Music, iTunes, etc. But of course you want to see the video, right? I'll be online in the chat tomorrow for the premiere at noon Eastern. I hope you all join me. I think it'll be fun. This song took me all year. I got to be honest with you. This was a tough one, but we pulled it together. And in fact, I gave a real big push for the. It's got to go out by the end of the year, so perhaps a New Year's show. But New Year's falls in the middle of the week, so the New Year's show will be December 26th. You know, Natasha Nix, happy holidays to you as well. Yeah, next Friday is Christmas, so it'll be Saturday. Do something Saturday. So tonight, this was something that showed up 2 weeks ago, and everyone was asking me last weekend, hey, you're going to show these pedals, and this took me some time to hook up and understand what's what. And it's kind of cool. I put a link in the description, but I did all my research like I always do, because, you know, every pedal has a story. Every pedal is influenced by something, and I kind of like to share that with you. What gauge strings do I use? I'm a lightweight man. I'm like 9 to 42, you know, that's what I like. Maybe 10 to 42, you know, something like that. So kind of keep it light on my fingers. I'm not a heavy gauge string guy by any means. Most guitars come with 10s, which are fine. But if I restring something, you know, 9 to 42 usually works, or 10 to 42, something like that. Or 10 to 46. But 10 to 46 is like the limit for me. All right, so shall we, I don't even know how long we're live here. Shall we check out some pedals? Shall we do that? You know, this pedal is by a company called Kayleen. Okay, they had reached out to me. They said, hey, do you want to check out? They sent me like a PDF of all these new pedals that they have. They're double pedals. And they're like, do you want to pick one? I'm like, you know what, just send them all. I'll go through. It's like hard, you know, nobody's ever heard these pedals. You know, it's like, how do you pick one from the artwork like that? No, you don't buy a pedal for the artwork, and you can't try these anywhere. So I figured send them all. I'll do a video. You'll have a nice video. Ron, dude, thank you so much, man. Thank you. And Ron, I will hang out till the end and answer your questions. So don't go anywhere. I will answer your questions. Thank you, dude. I appreciate that. Quentin James, 942 for your girly fingers. Yeah, I have pretty big fingers, but I'm just not into... I like to take it easy, you know what I mean? Okay, so let's talk about pedals. Now, they sent 11 pedals. This board supports, not 11, seven pedals. So there's four more, and I figured I'll do another video, okay, with four more. Glitch says you're friends with my son. That's interesting. Which son? And welcome, Glitch. Never heard of your name. Perhaps if I knew your real name, I would know who you are. But that's nice. Anytime, Ron. Christopher says, Colleen makes good pedals. The Englishman is great. Plexi style. You know what's interesting? Oh, Lorenzo. Okay. Cool. You should text Lorenzo. Tell him I'm live. And he could tune in. He's probably upstairs playing something. I watched some father and son time. I watched Back to the Future 1 and 2 with my son. And this weekend we'll watch Back to the Future 3. I got to tell you, if you have kids, here's my parenting advice. If you have kids, sit on the couch and watch a show with them. It's nice. Okay, so let's talk about pedals. Let's do that. And then at the end, I will do some Q&A and all that good stuff. This here, what we have here is seven pedals, again, by a company called Kaleen. And some of them are interesting pedals. So starting with this one, and we'll go one at a time, okay? This one here is called the Brutus. By the way, you like that overhead cam shot? There's no camera in my field of view, but you could see it nice and clear. You like that? Okay, anyway. So the Brutus. The Brutus is... This one here is an overdrive and a distortion, as it suggests. What the voice does, it switches overdrive into distortion or distortion into overdrive. So you could, you know, flip-flop. And I'll talk about that in a second. I keep losing my place here. Brutus. Okay. So the overdrive is basically a tube screamer. Okay. It uses the RC4558 chip, which is in many tube screamers, all from the TS-808 on. Okay. It's been used throughout. I think it's a Malaysian chip, not a Japanese chip, but I'm not a chip expert. You could look it up. But this is a tube screamer. And the distortion here is, they say it's based on the Diner Red. What's interesting is there are at least three companies I could find that make a pedal called the Diner Red, 68 pedals, one control, barefoot. And then, of course, Boss has the Diner Drive. Keeley has the Red Dirt. So I don't know. But this is like a Diner Red, and this is a tube screamer. So let's check this one out, and then we'll move on to the next one. So here we go. That's my clean sound. The pedals are going into the front of the Soldano Astro Verb, I guess it's called. So here we go. Yeah. So that's the Dyna and the Tube Screamer. I would say this pedal sounds pretty good. This voice thing, I'll be honest with you, there's no manual that comes with it. I couldn't tell if, like, does green mean left to right? I don't know what the green and the red means. But I could tell you, use your ears. And when I was on red, it didn't sound good. When I was on green, it sounded just fine. So my guess is on green, it was going overdrive to distortion, because that usually sounds fine to my ears. A distortion into an overdrive, not so fine. So I think the green might be left to right to left. That's my guess. Okay, so not bad. So this one here, the Key West. What is the Key West? The Key West here is a compressor and an overdrive. And the big thing here is the overdrive is supposed to be like a carbon copy of the Hermeter Drive Zen Drive pedal, which is exciting. So you have a regular compressor and a Zen Drive. So let's start here with the drive, because I want to hear how this sounds. I may even compare this to the Tube Screamer, and then we'll come back over here. Okay, here we go. So there it is. It definitely, the Zen Drive portion of this Key West pedal, I feel like it has a little bit more bite than this Tube Screamer inspired overdrive. However, I like this one better. I feel like I know what I want out of a Tube Screamer, and a lot of that top high end isn't really what I'm looking for. But this, I guess if you're into a Zen Drive, you have the tone and the voice, which are kind of both sound like tone controls to me. What do you think? What are your thoughts? Much better with the compressor? It's an overdrive, drive a dirty channel with it. I'm just trying to show each individual pedal as a standalone at the moment. So this one here is called the Brigade. Let's talk about the Brigade. And then when we're done, we'll mix and match. The Brigade. So this one is interesting. On the left, the overdrive is actually... Let's see something. In the description that I was sent, the Brigade on the left, tone, yeah, okay. So this is interesting. This is the Tube Screamer. So this and this should sound identical. We'll test that, okay? So this is the Tube Screamer. And the overdrive on the Brigade is, I was asked not to say this. So we'll play a game. It's a very sought-after exotic overdrive that rhymes with Jimmy. Anyone want to take a guess? I told them I wouldn't, you know, they said, by the way, don't say that. So I won't say that, but I'll tell you what it rhymes with. Sounds like Jimmy. Anyone want to take a guess? While you're guessing, I'm going to play both Tube Screamer and something that sounds like Jimmy. Here we go. The Dank Savage, DR Guitars. Yes, Quentin, not Lemmy. I like that guess, though. It's a good guess. Okay, here we go. I really like this overdrive right here. I think that's the best sounding one so far. What do you think? Nice transparent. Yeah, that was really nice. That sounded great. Okay, so now we're on to the Easy Driver. This is an interesting one. The Easy Driver is supposed to be a distortion for the Mesa Mark IV amp. And the EQ, oddly enough, the EQ, every band on the EQ is identical to a Boss GE7, okay? So you have a Mesa Mark IV inspired distortion that then goes into a GE7 inspired EQ. Need more cowbell? I have a cowbell in the other room. Okay. We'll be right back. was okay. Fesla, have a wonderful holiday. Looking forward to road trip later. Thank you, Fesla. I appreciate that. That was okay. I don't know if I'd say it sounds like a Mesa, but, you know, when they make it, maybe that was, you know, close. It sounds like, I do like that there's two gains. I don't know if you caught it. It's not just two gains. This is like a high-end gain. This is a low-end gain. And I purposely brought that up at about the 400 range, right? Because that's, I think, the sweet spot right over here. You know, made it a little crisp on the high end. It's kind of cool. You know what's funny? This is really very much like a Boogie style because Boogie always has the graphic EQ. They're big on the graphic EQ. So, you know, you get your distortion going in the EQ. I could understand why this would be, you know, inspired by, you know, a Mark series amp. I get it. Sounds like a Mach 2, not the newer ones. Yeah, well, the Mach 4 wasn't, you know, the Mach series was definitely not like the Rectifier series, right? It was more, I don't know, what kind of distortion would you call it? You know? Definitely has usable tones, I agree. Okay, let's go to this one. This one here is the, I don't know what that one's called. Tiger Shark. The writing is like very hard to read. The Tiger Shark is a their Bounty Hunter heavy metal pedal with a noise gate. I feel like I'm missing something here. Let me just read this real quick. Okay, I'm not missing anything. Okay, the Tiger Shark. Let's see. Yeah, the only pedal I know that has the built-in noise gate is the one that's made by... Well, let me ask you all. Let's make it fun. What high-gain pedals out there have noise gates in it? I can only think of one. Let's see if you're thinking of the one I'm thinking of. No, Dime Distortion doesn't have it. So the one I'm thinking of is the Amp Tweaker. Amp Tweaker has the gate in their pedals. Oh, does the Full Bore Metal have the noise gate? It may. You might be right. You might be right. EVH. Okay. So there's a few. All right, so let's try this one out. I'm going to kill the vocal mic. We'll be right back. I got to say, that's I like high gain. That's very, I don't know what the right high gain I'm thinking of here is. Not warm enough for me. I like my gain to have a little body and warmth and character. But if you're into that, there you go. Yeah, I feel like this sounds more like dime in a solid state amp sort of high gain. Anyone disagree with me? This feels like a dime style high gain, that real. And it's funny, I had the mids all the way up, but it still sounded scooped to me. Yeah, it's harsh. But if that's your thing, there you go. Now, moving on, we have a delay and a chorus, okay? Now, what's interesting for me is I would flip-flop these. And again, there's no right or wrong, but I like to have my delay right after my dirt. Anyone disagree? Where would you put the chorus? Chorus before the delay. Okay. Chorus first. Okay. After the dirt. Okay. So it looks like they built it for you guys. So let's go through it. I'm going to start with a clean. I'll add a delay. Well, I'll then turn that off, do a delay, and then maybe I'll run one of these. I'll run the this overdrive into that, and we'll see how that sounds. Here we go. Thank you. So there it is. What do you think? Nice 80s tone. Yeah, I think with a little bit of chorus, a little bit of delay, throw on a decent overdrive, and you definitely have an 80s tone. I would agree. Hello, Adam D. How are you, man? Okay, so last one. Now, this is interesting. This one here is called the Stellar EQ Compressor. And this one here is Stellar EQ. Stellar. Okay. Yeah, it's a six-band EQ and a compressor. That's an easy one. Actually, I purposely put this one at the end because I figured having all of this go into a compressor, I can actually control the overall level going into what you're receiving right now, which I kind of like. So let's hear what that sounds like. You know, I'm purposely banging the hell out of these strings just so you could see it's not clipping at all versus this. Hold your ears. So it definitely does a good job of compressing, okay? So now, with that compressed, I could turn the level up on anything and that'll compress it. I'll show you what I mean. Let's do this one. We'll be right back. there it is. Those are seven pedals that you got to check out. So there are four more. I'm going to put the guitar down, and then we'll chat. I'll answer questions, all that. Let me put this down over here. By the way, hang on. Let me come over here. Let's do this. Nope, wrong window. The Kiesel. Love this guitar. Okay, so that's the Kiesel. That's all off. We're back over here. My mic is on. I need to do this. Okay, yeah, we're at the right place. Okay, I'm sorry. Just trying to get my bearings. And I'm going to have a beverage. Quick little drink. Let's do a cheers. Cheers, everyone. Still not sponsored by Snapple. I'd like to be. Everyone sends Snapple an email. Tell them, I don't even want money. Just send me Snapples. In the blues. How you doing, dude? In the blues. Good man. He's a good man there. So in the blues, I want to show you something. I don't know when you joined, but you could see my space here, right? And check out this nice little overhead shot. Crystal clear. Nothing. Look at this. If you want to know how I did it, shoot me an email. I'll share with you the secret. Brian from Oregon. Hello, hello. Are you jamming too? Very cool. So what was everyone's favorite pedal? I'm curious to know what you think. What was your favorite? I like this one, the Brutus. Let me go back because I don't remember what was what now. This was really good. I happen to like this one a lot. This was the Dyna Red and the Tube Screamer. The Key West again was the Hermita Audio Zen Drive. That was okay. I like this one. That the one that rhymes with Jimmy was really nice. I like this. Believe it or not, this one cut through in the mix really nice. By itself, it was a little harsh, but in the mix was nice. This one, you know, it was okay. I feel like I could have, I feel like I like the overdrive and distortion on this better than this. And I actually happen to like this at the end. So if I had to pick anything, I would pick this one, the Brutus. I'd pick the Brigade, the Delay and Chorus, and this one. Those are the four, and maybe not, but this one, just because it cut through so nice. But I would say the four that impressed me the most were this one, the Brutus, the Brigade. Believe it or not, this one at the end, because you saw that I like the compressor at the and this having this at the end also really helps you fine tune the signal that goes out. So you could muck around with your pedals and control. It's kind of like a master volume right over here, which is really nice, and which I like at the end. So one, two. This is, you need a little delay in chorus, three and four. I would say those are my four favorite. Janice says, glad you're still on. Thank you, Janice. Grandpa Joe likes the Brutus also. Yeah, there was something I really like about this one. I think together it just really made a cut through. There are four more here. One is called the Night Wolf Overdrive. I'll show you what that looks like real quick. I didn't get to this, but next video I'll hook four more up. This one here is the Night Wolf Overdrive. Okay, that's one. The second one is the Sundance Special, which looks like this. Here's your Sundance Special. The third one is this one here. This is the Artemis Compressor and Boost. There's that one right there. And the last one that I didn't show anyone was, or that I didn't demo yet. So four more on the next video. And maybe what I'll do is I'll pick some of my favorites from here and include them. The overdrive, another overdrive, and another boost. this one right over here, which is called the Andes Boost Overdrive. The Andes. So, those are the other four. In fact, I should probably remember what's what. I'm probably going to get rid of... I'll unplug it so I know. So I have four more. I'm going to get rid of this. I'll unplug that. I'm going to get rid of this. I'll unplug that. I'll get rid of this. I'll unplug that. And I want to compare it to this. I want to compare it to this because I like that. Do you agree? Were these two everyone's favorites, the Brigade and the Brutus? Did anyone prefer another one here? Or do you think the Brigade and the Brutus were the winners? What are your thoughts? And then one more. I need to ditch one more. Maybe I'll ditch this one. I already ditched that one. So I ditched this one, the Key West. I ditched this one. I ditched the Easy Driver. And one more. Which one? One more should go. What should go? What do you think? I got to kill one more here when I hook these other four up. What do you think? Which one? The Brutus should go? Or is that your favorite? I know there's a time delay. Guitar Man 45. Oh, I wasn't showing you. I'm sorry. I apologize. I wasn't showing you the pedals. So this one is staying. The Brutus is staying. I unhooked the Key West. This is going to go. This one is staying, the Brigade. This one is going. This one is going. I figured I'd leave this for a little delay in chorus, and I kind of like this at the end. So far I have this disconnected, one, two, three. But I have four other pedals I want to show you. So which one should I... What's the other one I should get rid of for the next demo? What do you think? Number one, number two. Oh, you like the Key West, huh? It's funny, I was unhooking things and I thought you were able to see this and I realized afterwards. Thank you, Janice, for telling me about the overhead camera that I wasn't showing that. Get rid of the Stellar. Okay, yeah, we'll do that. Done. Yeah, because that's, yeah, I get it. Okay. So those are the four. One, two, three, four. Those will be gone, and I'll add four more for the next live show. If not the next, because the next one is the end of the year, the last live show of the year. I don't know if I'm going to cover this for that, but maybe in 2 weeks or something like that. Key West sounds like warm weather and bikinis. Motorbike pedal could go. Yeah. Okay, cool. So, where is Ron Cantrell in the chat? I know Ron had some questions, and if anybody else has any questions, let me have it. Ron, tell me what I could answer for you. I'm hoping he's still here. And while we're finding Ron, someone go out in the hall and see if Ron's in there. Tell him to come back in the room. DR, I agree. Maybe I'll get rid of the, just for the sake of the demo, maybe I'll get rid of the delay in the chorus because we know what that sounds like. And I really want to compare the other distortions to my two favorites. Would everyone agree number one and number three were the favorites? Anyone disagree with that? Metalhead Hippie. Okay, Ron Cantrell says, I'm running an ADA, a Triaxis, a Marshall JMP1 in a rack. How do I switch preamps? Do I need a switcher? So, Ron, what I am doing here, let me come back over here. Okay. So, if you notice, let me see if I could back up without knocking anything over. What I have over here is, actually, Ron, I'm going to give you one better, man. Bear with me 1 second. Go take a 30-second intermission. I'm going to get another camera, which I could hook up to this so I could give you a nice close-up. Be right with you. Okay. All right. Let's go back to my capture app. I'm connected. All right. We have a connection. And we are working. And let me check the audio on here. Let's do always follow audio. Okay, so what we have, and can everyone hear me on this? I just want to make sure everybody could hear me before I go through an explanation. Audio is fine. Okay, good. So I like my two preamps, and what we're looking at here is a 16 space rack, and I have a power amp, one power amp, an ADA, and I have my quad, my studio, my Soldano, my Jackson, my ADA MP1, and a GSP1101. Okay, now what's making this all possible are two units right here. The top unit is called a pedal pusher. The pedal pusher allows me to input one guitar and have eight outputs, okay? And I could also adjust gain and load, which gain just makes sure that what goes in is what goes out, and load does for impedance mismatch. And then output of that goes into each preamp, okay? And then the output of each preamp goes into a line mixer. So every preamp has its own line mixer. So in this particular case, my GSP is the first one, ADA is second one, Jackson is the third one, Soldano is the fourth, Studio is the fifth, Quad is the sixth, my Carvin Quad X, which is down there, is the seventh. So it's real simple. If you look over here, that is unselected. If I do that, it is muted. Right now, every preamp is muted. So if I want to play my Mesa Quad, I unmute it, and that's it. Everything else is ready to go. My guitar is plugged into here. Everything is live all the time. Now it's muted. Let's say I want to play my Mesa Studio. Well, it's one button. And that is how I, hold on, let me come back over here. That is how I toggle between different preamps. Basically, and I'll explain it now, you have one guitar that has to go into something that could then go to the input of every preamp, okay? I use an old, it's called a pedal pusher. It's one in, eight out, okay? One in and eight out. That gets me to the input of every preamp, okay? Now, the output of every preamp also has to go into something. I use a line mixer for that. So the output of every preamp goes into a line mixer. And then the output of the line mixer goes into one power amp. The way I control one at a time is by using the mute function per channel. And that's how I use, I mean, if I wanted to play all eight preamps at one time, I could do that, okay? But that would sound like running all, you know, seven or eight pedals at the same time, which won't sound good. So think about inputs and outputs. Ron, does that answer your question? I don't have a quadriverb. I wish I had a quadriverb. On my little step stool over here, yeah, I'll show you this. So let me come back over here. There we go. So on my, let me do this again. So this is my little stand over here is sitting on a four space rack, and those are the boxes to the pedals. They go all the way in the back. And below that is actually more rack storage. I have a power amp. I have two tube preamps by ART. I have a BBE 422A. I have an Intellifex, a MIDIverb 3, and a Digitech TSR 12. And those are you know, they're okay. You're very welcome, Ron. Hopefully that answers your question. I'll tell you this. You're going to have trouble finding that pedal pusher. They're out of production for many, many years. So you might be able to... You're still going to need something that has many outputs. That's the biggest challenge, is getting one input and eight outputs. In fact, hey, we have a smart community of guitarists here. I mean, mixers don't even have that many outputs. Anyone, even line mixers, it's more about inputs than it is outputs. Anyone know if a device out there today that you could buy that has a simple one input or one or two inputs and eight outputs, at least eight outputs? Anyone? It's kind of like a reverse mixer. That's what I like about the pedal pusher. It's like a reverse mixer. Hello, kitty. My cat is looking at me. I'll see if I could show you my cat real quick. Hold on. Oh, she just jumped off over there. Oh, where'd she go? She was somewhere. Okay. Yeah. I would put, it is a green screen. Quentin James photoshopped it for me. So in the blues, I'll show you my rig, by the way, since we're hanging out here. That's my overhead camera shot on the pedals. So that is going right to that. One more time. That is going right down to that. Right overhead, which is a good overhead shot. Vandenberg's a nice. So anyone, Ron, what you might want to do is definitely look for the pedal pusher. Maybe they come up on eBay or Reverb or something. Yes, you do know that camera. So In the Blues was my tech support for like the first week that I owned that camera. Ron, let me give it a little bit of thought on that. That's going to be a toughest thing, is finding a, like, guitar goes into something and then that goes out eight times into something. That's going to be the toughest thing. The pedal pusher is the perfect unit for that. The perfect unit. But they're and it was made for guitars. Yeah, look for the pedal pusher. I am not aware of any other unit that they made that was like that. I do know they make MIDI switchers, which gets a little bit more complicated, that have like many sends. You could look for, what is it called? Like a MIDI switcher, I guess. Like a Rocktron MIDI switcher, something like that. Steppenwolf like that pusher thing. Yeah. So a pedal pusher shouldn't cost you much more than $100. And the mixer I have, Eurorack Pro. It's a Behringer Eurorack Pro, and it's fine. It's eight channels, all stereo. And it also has like a line out on it also. So if you wanted to run that into something else, it has stereo outs, a line out, a headphone out. So even that is pretty cool. The nicest thing about the pedal pusher is that it has the impedance control on the front, which is really, you know, you don't get any loss. It has the gain and the impedance control. So if your pickups sound wonky, you could adjust it. And if your guitar sounds weak, you could adjust it. So that's really what you want to get, is if you could find the pedal pusher. Grumpy Mike, I'm within a week of being able to buy a second camera for my channel. Can't wait to get it. Which camera are you getting, Grumpy Mike? So, folks, before we wrap up, don't forget, tomorrow at noon Eastern, I am releasing the official music video of Road Trip. I'm very proud of how it came out. And I'm not sure if you saw the teaser. By the way, Trey from Gear Gods did the solo on that. He knocked it out of the park. It's just, he spent 6 hours on that solo, which blew me away. He was very committed and dedicated to doing it right, and I am crazy grateful for that. And, of course, my buddy Kyle that, you know, produced the whole thing. It's, I mean, there were collectively many hours that went into this song. And it's funny, I sang on it, and every time I sang on it, I was all proud of myself, and I send it to Kyle. And I always tell everyone, just be honest with me. Don't lie to me. Just be honest with me. And he's like, yeah, can you do it again? Can you give me another take? I went through many takes, and I would send him the other take. I'd send him like two or three at a time, like, yeah, I got it done. Dude, can you let me know what you think? Be honest with me. And he's like, maybe a few more takes? Can you send me a few more? So, you know, folks, I got to tell you that I love everything behind me. And it's really easy to plug into an amp and fiddle a noodle. It's really hard, for me anyway. It's really hard to make music. And when I say make music, I'm talking the finished product. It's really hard. It's not easy. For me, it's not easy. I mean, I hear some of these YouTubers, YouTube guitar guys that make a song in every video. It's impressive. I can't do that. And you know what? I like to think that I'm a litmus test. I probably am like a lot of you, right? You know, we love to noodle on the guitar. We fiddle around in our free time. But when you have to sit down from start to finish, construct a song, put words to a song, sing a song, go through edit upon edit upon edit upon edit, and then even with the solos, in fact, Kyle had come to me and said, dude, I'd like to do the solo. And I said, great. And again, this is a relationship about trust and honesty. And he came back to me, he said, dude, I'm not really happy with what I'm producing for the solo. He goes, you know, if I want to do it, or my buddy Joe, and who did the last solo, and Joe had a problem with his hand. I hope he feels better if he's watching this. I thought and thought and thought and thought, who's the right person to ask? And I asked Trey, you know, because I told him, I said, dude, I'm giving you a gift. He goes, what's the gift? I said, I'm coming to you. You know, because we know a lot of guitarists, but it was, I wanted him to know that I thought of him, and, I knew, and let me tell you, the guy knocked it out of the park. In the Blues says, recording is a huge job. It's worse if you have to produce it yourself as well, because it's a rabbit hole for everything creative. Absolutely. And I'm very lucky that I have Kyle on my side that does that for me. And I got to tell you, he's the one turning the knobs and the dials, but it's like we're sitting there together. There's probably 200 emails between us for the song. On 3 minutes and 15 seconds, can you raise this? On 4 minutes and 12 seconds, between this timestamp and that timestamp, let's do that. It's like literally second by second, we're going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. You need the patience of a saint. You really do. You need the patience of a saint to make music with someone. Because when you care and you want to get it right, you're listening to every note, every nuance, every this, every that. And that, let me tell you, it takes patience and it takes time. And when you find the right synergy to do that with someone, it's priceless. It really is, because it's not easy. It's not easy. Like I said, for me, it's not easy. So I'm very proud of the song. I love how it came out. I can't wait to share it all with you. So meet me in the chat tomorrow at noon Eastern. And if you do want to comment, again, Gear Gods, Trey from Gear Gods was did the solo. So if you want to comment, you know, shoot him a note, let him know what you think by all means. And Kyle's from Gearing Up. He hasn't done much with his channel for a while. He had some other priorities come up, but he's still committed to making music. In fact, I don't want to tell you what my New Year's resolution is. I'll wait until next week, but Kyle is in that New Year's resolution. We're really going to push ourselves to do something that is going to seem impossible for me to do, but you'll want to tune into next week's live show. My fellow rockers, for my Patreons in the house, tomorrow night, 10:30 p.m. Eastern, we have our show. I probably won't talk to you all before Christmas, so I hope everyone has a great Christmas. Ron, let me know if that answers your question. Shoot me an email, and just remind me. I'll put a pedal pusher on my my Reverb and my eBay like saved list, search list, and if I see one, I'll shoot you a note. But hopefully that helps you out. And I'm glad you came to the live show so I could show you the video. And it's just hard to explain all that in an email. That's why I don't want you to think I'm being standoffish. So for those that know, Ron sent me an email. It was like simple. It was one question, which is good, by the way. Sometimes you get emails that are like five paragraphs. It's like, come on, can't you make it a sentence for me? And he does. And Ron, I appreciate that. Unfortunately, that was a very long answer. So thank you for coming on the show and giving me an opportunity to explain it to you live. I think that probably was better than the back and forth. If I'm going back and forth on email, I'm making music. Great Vanzini, Merry Christmas. I know we all probably celebrate something else. For those that celebrate Christmas, as I do, Merry Christmas. I'm not sure if Hanukkah is still going on. I know it was last week. If it is still going on, happy Hanukkah. Whatever it is that you celebrate, I wish you a happy celebration. Merry Christmas, all that good stuff. I will have a live show next Saturday, not Friday. Friday's Christmas. We should be with our families. Oh, Roy Batty says, people that write a book are usually crazy. Dude, tune into my next week's live show. Write that again in next week's live show comment. Make sure I acknowledge that comment in next week's live show. Brian from Oregon, see you tomorrow night. Grandpa Joe, see you tomorrow night. Ron, it is better live, Ron. And usually it's every Friday night. When I'm really tired, it'll be Saturday night. But usually it's Friday night. I've been doing live shows before YouTube had a live show feature. So who in the house? By the way, come on, guys, give me some thumbs up. There's 100 of you in here. I have 57 thumbs up. Let's get to 100. Come on. So who used to follow me when I was doing it on, was it Livestream? I think it was Livestream. Did anyone ever watch my live show before YouTube had a live feature? That's how long I've been doing live shows. And I had to go to Livestream. Anyone here that saw me on live stream back in the day? I'm just watching all the comments. Okay, folks. Michael was. Thank you, Michael. All right, my fellow rockers, I am out of here. DR, Natasha, thank you. Grandpa Joe, Jordan, Dog PA, Michael, Ron Cantrell, Brian from Oregon, Grumpy Mike. That was before your time. Tim Buck 2, Great Vanzini. You think you remember that? Folks, found me through watching videos about Kiesel guitars. And you got to see me play the Kiesel tonight. It was meant to be. Folks, have a great night. Have a great weekend. I'll see you tomorrow, noon Eastern. Be there. And if you're not there, that's okay. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. I wish you health, happiness, success, all that good stuff. I'm going to leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. I will see you all later. Thank you. Rock on.